Ogwefi. Like we all know, this video is to assist or to mentor or to help people that are doing the same line of business. Kindly share, thumbs up, ask us questions, throw in your concerns, and we'll be able to assist in our own little way. In this video, I want to talk about the importance of bookkeeping or proper documentation, depending on how you want to see it or call it. It's very good as a business person to have documentation, to have bookkeeping. It's helped you in various ways. Number one, if you're used to your old ways of recording in your long books, ledger, big notes, whatever it is that you use, it's called a hard copy and it's old fashioned. Hard copies can be misplaced at any given time. We advise you use soft copy, whereby you document your daily record on your laptop, your desktop, your device, any form of device that you have. This helps because it can be saved properly. You can even save it in the clouds. It helps you to, you know, have access to it at any time, anywhere, any place. The other reason why it's good to have a proper documentation is it helps you to know what your cash flow is like. Cash flow is the money coming in and the money going out. If you don't have proper bookkeeping, you're unable to assess this. Also, I'd like to let you know that proper documentation or bookkeeping helps you in your financial obligation. This is people that are owing you or people you owe. Maybe your vendors that supply some form of consumables to you. If you don't have proper documentation, you're unable to assess it. You're unable to know when you're owing, if you have paid and if you have not paid. But if you have a proper bookkeeping, it helps you and you're able to attend to your financial obligation. Lastly, I'd like to say that bookkeeping also helps you in investment plans. What I mean by investment plans is, as a business owner, it's not just about spending money on your consumables or paying salaries or all that. Sometimes you have money saved and you want to invest back into the business, or you might even want to try other businesses. If you don't have records, you don't know what you have saved down, you don't know what you have fixed, maybe you have a fixed deposit. If you have proper record, you're able to tell all this. I'll also like to show you guys how to document on your Excel. If you don't have accounting apps, you can use your normal Microsoft Excel on your laptops, your Android phones, your iPads, your desktop, whatever device you have available. You should try as much as possible to put your documentation on a soft copy so that in future, or for one reason or the other, if there's a need for you to access it, it will be easily accessible. Unlike the old-fashioned way of hard copy, which can be burnt, you know, soaked, torn, different million reasons why so hard copy is not advisable. At least in this time and age, things have improved. So I advise we improve with technology. So I'm going to be showing you now how to use the Microsoft Excel. Okay, so for the columns, we can have our date, have names, that's your customer's names, your invoice number, if you use one, I'll shorten it, invoice number. You can have quantity, that is quantity of your items, and many columns as possible, depending on the number of columns you want to have. You can have description of items here, yeah? And so amount, and you drag to extend your, to make sure your column, this one is a mistake, so to make sure your column fits, the lettering fits in, you can drag it. So this is description. We go to the next one. You can put the amount, that's what we have charged, and as many columns as possible. Okay, so you put your date in that particular role and you highlight the date in case you have more than one customer per day. So highlight it, copy, and you can use Control C to copy, and then you highlight how many, you drag it down to the number of days you want to put there, or number of times you want the date to appear. So once you highlight it, you copy and you drop it and you paste. So it automatically brings the date down. So I'm filling in the name. We had Ade. We had Ife, or Ife rather. We had Daniel. And we also had Gail on that day. So let's assume for Mr. Ade, invoice number is 75. The next one is 76. Next one is 77, 78. We have our quantity. Maybe this man brought 50 items. The next one brought 1. The next one brought 12. And the other person brought 5. For the description, let's say this person brought 10 shirts, 10 jeans, 10 natives, 10 t-shirts, 10 t-shirts, and 10 duvets. The next person, 1 shirt, 1 shirt. The last person, the third person rather, maybe 4 jeans, 5 trousers, and 1 jacket. And lastly, the last person just brought 5 curtains. So you extend this to accommodate all you have typed. Next column, we have the amount. We can say this one is 25. Next, maybe 200. This one, 15. Lastly, maybe 5,000. This is just examples. They are not accurate figures because know how you're going to wash 50 items for 25, just for the benefit of the video. Okay, so we need to sum up the total, but before that we can come here and type our total. Then for us to get the sum, you come to the first amount and you highlight to the last. You drag it down and you can stop at exactly where your total is so that your results will come out there. Okay? So once that is done, you go to your formulas, you go to auto sum, and it brings out the result. This is just the easiest way of doing it. It brings out the sum. Also, you can edit, you can make your titles bold, you can change the font for you to get accurate stuff on your Excel. Normally Excel saves as book 2, but you can give it a name that is easy for you to remember. So you go to file. In order to do that, you go to file and go to save as. When you go to save as, the box comes out. You save under your documents, and it's, the file name is book 2, but you change it to what you can easily remember. So I can change this to my week 1, for instance, and I save it. Once I save it, it automatically changes to that name, which I can remember. Thank you for watching the video. I hope it has been impactful. Kindly subscribe, like, and share so that I can help someone. See you in the next video. Bye.